أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب وقفينا من بعده بالرسل وآتينا عيسى ابن مريم البينات وأيدناه بروح القدس. أفكلما جاءكم رسول بما لا تهوى أنفسكم استكبرتم ففريقا كذبتم وفريقا تقتلون وقالوا قلوبنا غلف بل لعنهم الله بكفرهم فقليلا ما يؤمنون. صدق الله. So today we are going to read the translation of ayat number 77-78 and maybe more inshallah. We start from here. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about his Bani Israel, وَلَقَدْ, yep, wa means la, indeed, قَدْ, verily, in the same meaning. So قَدْ basically comes where? To fi'lul madhi, for example, to make madhi, yep, and what do you call the very strong. So something happened, yes, verily. So وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا, so indeed, verily, Ataina, we gave Musa alayhi salam al-kitaba. What was the book? Torah. So Musa alayhi salam was given the Torah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this, that we have given Torah to Musa alayhi salam, and after Musa alayhi salam, waqafaina, and qafaina up mean from ba'dihi, after him, bir rusul, with messengers. So after Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says we have sent many prophets, many messengers. So after Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, they are from Banu Israel. And one of them, of course, Isa alayhi salam as well. Wa ataina, and we gave Isa ibn Maryam, Isa ibn son Maryam, Maryam son of Maryam, Isa ibn Maryam son of Maryam, what? Al bayyinat, clear signs, many signs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Isa alayhi salam. In part 3, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, in part 7 as well, many signs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. And وَأَيَّدْنَاهُ, and أَيَّدْنَا, we supported who? Him. And we have supported him with whom? بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ, with Holy Spirit. Ruh means Spirit. Al-Qudus, holy. So we supported him with Ruh al-Qudus. Who is Ruh al-Qudus? Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Basically, with the nafakh, with the blow of Jibreel, he born. And Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam supported him in many occasions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says we supported him with the Ruh al-Qudus. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Torah to Musa alayhi salam. After Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent many prophets after him and the messengers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the, Allah mentioned about the Isa alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that we gave him a lot of signs. People, they died. So he can see, okay, qum bi iznillah, stand up with the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the dead person, you know, became alive and start talking, and the people what they eat, Mr. Aslam can say, okay, what you ate or what is stored in your home. Okay, if a person is very sick, alhamdulillah, or the person got any sort of sickness, so alhamdulillah, with his dua, person become cured, got the shifa. So Allah subhanahu gave him a lot of sign, the bayyinat. to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, all bi-iznillah, with the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, afa kullama ja'akum. So, afa, a, this question, fa, so kullama, so whenever ja'akum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Banu Israel, to this Yahud, to you who Rasulun, whenever the messenger come to you, any messenger come to you, bima, with what the best messenger, la tahwa, do not desire, or doesn't you people, anfusakum, yourself, you do not want, you do not desire, you do not like them, your nafs, yourself. What do you do? Istakbartum. See? So you basically acted arrogantly, so you became mutakabbir. You are not listening, you do not listen. That messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the whenever the Rasul come to you, must listen to him, must believe in him. This is part of Iman. The current messenger, a messenger comes to you, then you have to believe in him. But these people, they say no. These people, they say, no, we do not like Na'uzubillah, 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 this messenger. And they become so arrogant. And on top of that, what they do? This Yahud, فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ. Fariq, Jamaat, party, group. So one group, كَذَّبْتُمْ, denied. So do not accept him. You refuse. The messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one group were doing like this from the Bani Israel, and other group, Na'uzubillah min zalik, wa fariqan, and a party, there's another jamaat, another party, another group, faqtulun. Okay? So that was the Na'uzubillah hobby of them, these Yahud. They used to kill the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Sometime in one day, they have killed 70 prophets in different villages, in different areas. Na'uzubillah min zalik. So yaqtulun al-anbiya bighayri haqq. So they are the criminals. So you can imagine their act. They used to kill the anbiya. Killing a human being is haram. What about the killing of the anbiya? Na'uzubillah min zalik. Nothing is worse than this thing. These people, these Yahud, they used to kill Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Whenever they come to him, he's a prophet of Allah, they start doing silly things, they are doing to kill, trying to kill Na'uzu Ibrahim. So this Yahud, so they claim for many things, you can see their act. They do not believe in Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, and then they refuse. And then they used to kill the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. And what they have said? Waqalu, they said, Qulubuna, our heart, what? Gulfun, red, the ghilaf covered. So we have the ghilaf, okay? Na'uzubillah min zalik. So this means, this, because of this ghilaf, this is finished. We are not going to accept. It is true, the ghilaf of Zulma. Ghilaf of Zulma, the darkness. That's why nothing is going inside the heart. And the last one says, Bal. But, La'anahumullahu. La'ana, La'ana, curse. Whom? Then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse them. Why? This ba is the reason. This ba is the reason. B, because kufrihim, because of their kufr, because of their kufr, so disbelief. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse upon them. So Allah's curse upon them. So how come then they are going to accept the Islam? How come they will accept the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? In the past, these people, they used to kill the Anbiya alayhi wa sallam. They used to refuse the Anbiya alayhi wa sallam. They were so arrogant. The same thing here. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Messenger of Allah, do not grieve. Do not worry about these people. If they do not accept you, don't worry. These people, they used to kill the Anbiya alayhi sallam. And they were trying to kill the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well. They made a plan to kill Na'uzubillah Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They tried. So faqal sufa qalilan, let him ma what yu'minun. They believe. So very little of them they believe, like Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu ta'ala and some companion. Okay, so they mashallah accepted Islam from the Yahud. Very little number from them amongst the Yahud. So this is the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you do not upset, do not grieve, do not worry about them, because that is their attitude. They used to do like this. If they do not believe in you, you don't have to worry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, walamma, and lamma, say please. Okay, ja'ahum, came to them what? Kitabun, a book from min indillahi, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The book musaddiqun, this is not any this book then. This book basically recognize musaddiq, confirming, recognizing lima what, yep, what was ma'ahum, with them, what was with them. So this book recognized, confirming that the book you have, that the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and recognizing that this book is the true book, what you have, I mean the Torah. So the other book recognized, like Quran for example, that this Quran basically confirming the about the Torah. The Torah is the true book. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Musa alayhi salam. The Quran is the Musaddiq. Quran is the Musaddiq. So confirms, Quran confirms about this book, what they have. That means the Torah. Wakanu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about this Yahud, wakanu, yep, they used to, or they were, min qablu, before, yastaftihuna, they used to pray for the victory, dina upon or over, ala over or upon whom, alladina kafaru, Buddhist spirit. So they used to make dua, pray, Allah give us the victory on the kuffar. So وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقُ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. So see, I'm saying that when the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them, I mean the Quran, the Holy Quran, this Quran مُصَدِّقُ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ, confirming, recognizing what they have, I mean they brought the Torah. And they used to make dua in the past, before, min qabl, means before Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. You know, when they used to fight each other, and then the other party got the victory against them, then they used to make dua, Allah, we know that there will be a Prophet come, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. They used to ask Allah, send this messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Yastaftihuna, this Fatiha, they used to do the Fatiha, they used to do the dua, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, send Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the rahmatul alameen. So when he will come, then we'll get the success and we'll get upper hand on the kuffar. Subhanallah. Because in the book, in the Torah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention about the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, his name, he will be from the child of Bani Ismail. And he will be from Arab. His name will be this. And every single thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they knew about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam very well, like their kids. يَعْرِفُونَ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَهُمْ, like they know about their kids. Is there any doubt a person by saying, oh, I don't know if he is my kid or not? amongst the thousand, he can say he is my son. Anyway, so these people, they already know about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But what happened? See, falamma. So, lamma, when, jaa, came, whom, them, who, what, ma arafu, what they recognized, they knew. What they knew, yani about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to them, they already knew about him through their books. They used to make dua. They used to do the Fatiha. Okay, Allah sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last messenger. When he will come, and everything will be fine, and all the problem will be solved. So now when he came, ma arafu, what they know, what they knew. But what happened? These people, kafaru bi. Kafaru, that is bi. Bihi, in it. Means they did not believe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. They see these people, these Yahud. Yani on purpose. I can tell you the reason. What the reason? Basically, when they come to know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is from Banu Ismail, they said, why not from Banu Ishaq? Ibrahim alayhi salam has got two sons, Ismail alayhi salam and Ishaq alayhi salam. And all the prophets, all the messengers come from Ishaq alayhi salam till Isa alayhi salam with this chain. And from Ismail alayhi salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, there was no messenger, no prophet in between. From Ismail alayhi salam, the direct Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The reason, basically, you know, if you remember, that when Ismail and Ibrahim alayhi wasallam, when they were building the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Ismail sallam was asking with his father Ibrahim sallam about whom Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So because they were making the dua of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, of course Ismail alayhi wa sallam was with him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the dua. That's why directly from Ismail alayhi wa sallam, who came the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In between, no Nabi, no Rasul. But this Yahud, because they are from Banu Ishaq, they are from Banu Ishaq, and these people, you know, the Ishaq alayhi salam's son was Yaqub. Yaqub alayhi salatu salam, he is basically, his name is Israel. Israel, Abdullah. Remember? I explained to you in the past. So from him, Banu Israel, the child of Israel. So then now they say, if the Prophet Muhammad means he is from Banu Ishaq, then we will accept. Because he is not Banu Ishaq, these stupid people, they must think, who is the father of both? Say Ibrahim alayhi salam. Who is the father of Ishaq? Ibrahim alayhi salam. Who is the father of Ismail alayhi salam? Who? Ibrahim alayhi salam. From one father. But these are stupid people. Allah subhanahu said, Sufaha, these people, these Yod are stupid. So now see here, only because of this, they said, no, we're not going to accept Prophet Muhammad sallallahu in ghazab. See, falla'natullah. So, because of Allah, of Allah, upon, on whom? Al-Kafirin. So Allah's curse upon these people, this kuffar. Allah subhanahu says, further, bi'isama. Bi'isa means evil, bad. Ma, what? Ishtarau, they have sold, bihi, with anfusahum, themselves. They sold themselves. So they are not the good businessmen. The Muslims, subhanallah, they sell themselves, their soul, their nafs, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they buy the Jannah. But these people, they sold themselves and they got what? Against this kufr. So they are the losers. And that yakfuru. This belief. What bima in? What? Anzal Allah. What Allah revealed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So they disobey. They did not believe in that. So what they are trying to achieve? So they basically, they sold themselves, they bought what? The kufr. And what, why? The reason? Baghyan. That's the reason. Okay? So because of the bagh, and because of the jealousy, because of the books, أَنْ يُنَزِّلَ اللَّهُ. So why? Because أَنْ يُنَزِّلَ اللَّهُ, that يُنَزِّلَ, yes, send down Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mean of or from fadlihi, his grace, his fadl. So yani what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed from with his fazal, with his mercy, okay, ala upon or on man whom yasha'u, he wills, mean from ibadihi, his servants. So what basically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, reveal upon someone from his servant, who? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran on him. So they should accept, but not. They denied because of the enmity, bagh in their heart, and that they refuse. Faba'u. So they drawn or they returned or they took bi ghadabin, the wrath, the ghazab, ala ghadab, ghadab on ghadab, wrath on wrath. Of course. So whenever they go, Allah's wrath upon them, these people. And Allah's anger upon them all the time. So when we recite the Surah Al-Fatiha, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ, who are they? The Yahud, these people, this ghadab, the Allah's ghadab upon them, so these people. وَلِلْكَافِرِينَ, and for the kuffar, عَذَابٌ, a punishment, مُهِينٌ, humiliating. So humiliating azab will be for this kuffar. Kafir means here, Yahud. So for this Yahud, there will be the humiliating azab. Why? Because they did not accept the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why. Okay, we leave here for today, inshallah.